Ramadan vocabulary and phrases. Hi everyone, welcome back again to You English. In this video, you are going to learn some vocabulary and expressions related to fasting and Ramadan. Here we go. Number 1, the five pillars of Islam. The five pillars of Islam are some basic acts in Islam considered mandatory by believers and are the foundation of Muslim life. They are Shahada, Salah, Zakah, Fasting, and Hajj. The five pillars of Islam artinya lima rukun Islam. Pillar number one, Shahada. It is believed that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is his messenger. It is the declaration of faith. One becomes a Muslim by reciting this phrase with conviction. Shahada, the Muslim profession of faith. Membaca syahadat. Number 2, prayer or salah. Salah is performing ritual prayers in the proper way. Muslims pray facing Mecca 5 times a day, at dawn, noon, mid-afternoon, sunset, and after dark. Prayer or salah artinya sholat. Here we have obligatory prayer, sholat fardu atau wajib, recommended or sunnah prayer, sholat sunnah, and congregational prayer, sholat berjamaah, yaitu sholat yang dilaksanakan secara bersama-sama. Next, perform ablution. An ablution is a washing or a cleaning of oneself for personal hygiene, or ritual washing or cleaning associated with religious observance. To perform ablution artinya berwudu. Before you pray, you must perform ablution. Sebelum melaksanakan sholat, kamu harus berwudu dulu. Have you performed ablution yet? Kamu sudah berwudu atau belum? Yes, I have. Ya, saya sudah berwudu. Or you can say, no, not yet. I have not performed my ablution yet. Saya belum wudu. Next, almsgiving. In accordance with Islamic law, Muslims pay an alms or charity tax. They donate a fixed portion of their income to the poor and the needy in other community members or other community members in need. The poor and the needy artinya adalah orang-orang yang miskin dan yang membutuhkan. Almsgiving berarti zakat. Next, fasting. Fasting during Ramadan means more than abstaining from food and drink from dawn to dusk. During Ramadan, one must also avoid sexual activity, arguing, gossip, expressions of anger, and envy. Fasting or to fast artinya berpuasa. Are you fasting today? Apakah kamu hari ini berpuasa? No, I've got my period, so I'm not fasting. I've got my period artinya saya sedang datang bulan. Fasting helps to cleanse the body. During fasting, it is forbidden to eat and drink. Selama berpuasa, kita dilarang untuk makan dan minum. Pillars number 5, Hajj or the pilgrimage to Mecca. For those Muslims who are physically and financially able to make the journey to Mecca, the Hajj is a once-in-a-lifetime duty that is the peak of their religious life. Hajj or the pilgrimage to Mecca artinya pergi haji. Most Muslims try to go on a pilgrimage to Mecca at least once in their life. Pak Abdul was in his pilgrimage to Mecca when he was ill. Saat pergi haji, Pak Abdul jatuh sakit. My parents made a pilgrimage to Mecca last year. Orang tuaku pergi haji tahun lalu. Next, Ramadan. Ramadan is the ninth month of the Islamic calendar. It is the month in which the Quran was revealed to Prophet Muhammad PPUH. PPUH, peace be upon him, biasanya kita menyebut dengan Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, SAW. Ramadan is coming, it starts tomorrow. Ramadan tiba, kita besok mulai berpuasa. Marhaban ya Ramadan, selamat datang bulan Ramadan. Welcome Ramadan. Ramadan Mubarak. While wishing people happy Ramadan isn't offensive or inaccurate, Most Muslims usually use the Arabic translation Ramadan Mubarak to greet each other during Ramadan. Ramadan Mubarak, selamat menunaikan ibadah puasa. Ramadan Mubarak, everyone. Ramadan Mubarak, wishing you a blessed and happy Ramadan. May Allah bless you and your family. Semoga Allah memberkatimu dan keluargamu. May He ease your hardships and shower you with lots of peace and prosperity during this holy month. Have a blessed time. Hardships artinya adalah penderitaan dan prosperity artinya adalah kesejahteraan. Next, observe Ramadan. To observe Ramadan means to obey, to fulfill, to celebrate, or to comply with Ramadan. The observance of Ramadan is considered one of the five pillars of Islam. To observe Ramadan berarti menunaikan ibadah puasa di bulan Ramadan. Each year, Muslims throughout the world observe the holy month of Ramadan, which falls during the ninth lunar cycle of the Islamic calendar. Jadi di sini observe Ramadan bukan berarti memperhatikan Ramadan, tapi di sini berarti mentaati, melaksanakan, dan menjalankan semua yang diperintahkan untuk dilaksanakan di bulan Ramadan. Next, iftar. Iftar is an Arabic term that is used to describe the evening meal that Muslims eat to break their daily fast after sunset during the holy month of Ramadan. Iftar berasal dari bahasa Arab futur yang sebenarnya berarti sarapan. Iftar, berbuka puasa. What are we having for iftar, Mom? Menu buka puasa kita apa hari ini? We are having dates and chicken stew. Yay, I love chicken stew. Dates berarti buah kurma yang biasa dimakan saat berbuka puasa. Untuk mengatakan selamat berbuka puasa, you can say enjoy your feast, enjoy breaking your fast, or enjoy your iftar. Selamat berbuka. Next, iftar gathering. Iftar gathering is when you gather with family and friends or colleagues at sundown for a communal breaking of the fast and then spend the evening eating and catching up on social visits and entertainment. Iftar gathering, berbuka puasa bersama atau bukber. Many Muslims are finding creative ways to have iftar gathering via social media. Social platforms such as Zoom, Google Hangouts, and Skype. They call it virtual iftar or remote iftar. Iftar jarak jauh. Let's have iftar gathering next week. Ayo kita buka puasa bersama minggu depan. Sahur. Sahur or pre-dawn meal is an Islamic term referring to the meal consumed early in the morning by Muslims before fasting. You can also say sahur or sehri, yang berarti makan sahur, yaitu pre-dawn meal, makan sahur. Sahur is not mandatory part of fasting, but it is the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My brother didn't have sahur because he didn't wake up for his pre-dawn meal last night. Kakakku tidak sahur gara-gara dia tidak bangun tadi malam. Dawn. Dawn is the first appearance of light in the sky before sunrise. Dawn artinya fajar. Dusk. Dusk is the time just before the night when the daylight has almost gone, but when it is not completely dark. Dusk, senja. Tarawih. Tarawih refers to additional ritual prayers performed by Muslims at night after the Isya prayer during the holy month of Ramadan. Tarawih atau sholat tarawih adalah sholat sunnah yang dilaksanakan setelah sholat Isya oleh umat Islam selama bulan Ramadan. Some mosques were not allowed to hold tarawih prayers during Ramadan because of the coronavirus pandemic. Beberapa masjid dilarang mengadakan sholat tarawih karena ada coronavirus pandemic, karena ada virus corona. Hold tarawih prayer, melaksanakan sholat tarawih. Quran recitation. Quran recitation refers to the act of reciting or reading verses of the Holy Quran out loud from memory or direct reading from the book. Quran recitation artinya adalah tadarus, yaitu membaca Quran dengan suara yang keras, out loud, bukan di dalam hati. Quran recitation is an important religious ritual for Muslims, especially during Ramadan. Let's recite the Holy Quran in masjid, after tarawih prayer. Ayo kita tadarusan di masjid setelah sholat isya. You can say masjid or mosque, karena kebanyakan istilah ini langsung diserap dari bahasa Arab. Next, Idul Fitri. At the conclusion of Ramadan, Muslims celebrate the holiday of Idul Fitri, the festival of breaking the fast. It begins with the communal Eid prayer. Idul Fitri, Hari Raya Lebaran atau Hari Raya Idul Fitri. Eid or Idul Fitri is one of the major festival of the Muslim community and is celebrated with great joy and enthusiasm across the world. Jadi Idul Fitri ini adalah hari raya yang dilaksanakan dan diperingati oleh umat Islam di seluruh dunia dengan rasa sukacita. Next, homecoming. By the end of Ramadan, most Muslims, especially in Indonesia, they go back to their hometown to celebrate Idul Fitri with their family. Homecoming, mudik. Homecoming ini biasanya dilaksanakan di Indonesia. Mereka pulang ke kampung halaman untuk merayakan Idul Fitri. Homecoming has been practiced by most Indonesians as a routine tradition that is cherished every year. Jadi homecoming ini memang biasa dilakukan di Indonesia. My kids are always looking forward to homecoming every Ramadan. Homecoming atau mudik ini memang acara yang ditunggu-tunggu oleh anak-anak dan juga orang tuanya. Next, Muslim or Muslim scholars. The term ulama or Muslim scholar literally means those who possess knowledge or ilm, particularly in Islam. Here we have other Ramadan vocabulary and phrases. First, obligatory, yang berarti wajib. Fasting during the month of Ramadan is one of the five pillars of Islam. It is obligatory for all adult Muslims with few exceptions. Jadi, berpuasa di bulan Ramadan ini hukumnya adalah wajib dilaksanakan oleh semua umat Islam yang telah baligh. Next, warning signal before the fast begins. Imsak. It is good to stop eating and drinking when you hear imsak from masjid or from mosque. Jadi lebih baik berhenti untuk makan dan minum jika kita sudah mendengar suara imsak dari masjid. Killing time or passing time before iftar. Ngabuburit. Let's go kill some time before maghrib. Oke, ayo kita ngabuburit yuk. Ayo. Here we have also ruin or break one's fast, yaitu membatalkan puasa. Intentional eating, drinking, and vomiting can break your fast. Jadi muntah dengan disengaja bisa membatalkan puasa. Don't get angry or you ruin your fast. Jangan marah dong, nanti puasamu bisa batal loh. Prayer cap, kopiah. Prayer rug, sajadah. Prayer beads, tasbih. Prayer dress, mukena, and sarong, artinya sarung. Sin berarti dosa, dan reward berarti pahala. So, I think that's it. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe for more videos. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let me know by writing in the comments.